Therefore, we will use partition method. Now, what do we have in partition method? We have classes depending upon the output. So there are two type of output, whether output will be 0 or the output will be 0, 1. So let me define two classes there. Classes 0, 0 and 0, 1 is there. So I can name them. So this will be the class P and this will be the class Q. And state in class, how many states are there associated with P class? Means these two states, S0 and S1. See, S0 and S1 give are in the 0, 0, 0, 0 output. So what we have here is S0 and S1 state is available with class P. And S2 state is with class Q. Now, these are the class present. Now, what will be the next state? Means what? S0's next class. So X0's next class will be S0 when input is 0 or S1 when input is 1. So both the S0's and S1, they are in P class. So what I will write here for S0, the class is P, P, P. And for the S1, the next states are, is the present state is S1 and next state are S2 and S1. So S2 is from Q class. So I will write down here Q, comma, and S1 is from P class. So I'll write on P here. And as far as S2 is concerned, S2 is going to S0, that is nothing but P class. And S2 is going to S1 in the next class. So S1 is from P class. So again, it will be P comma P. Now we need to reduce these expressions. So we'll continue the partition method. We have here the next class PP, QP and PP. Classes associated with us are the P and Q. So I'll write down the classes P and Q. So starting with the P class, first element or the first state in the class is S0. Since S0 goes to S0, so I will write down here S0 first. So this is S0. So talking about S0, so S0 goes to S0. That is the same class P, so I will write down here P. S0's next class will be S1 and S1 is again with P. So instead of going around P and P and P, so what I will write down, since S0 is both the next classes in P, so I'll introduce a new class that is nothing but class R. So class R will be introduced here, in which I'll put the element S1. S0 moves to S1, that is nothing but R class. So I will write down here P, R. P class S0 we have done. So for S0 goes to S0, P I have written. S0 goes to S1, which is the same class. So I will move down to this S1 to the new class, that is R. So S0, S1 and over in the P class. And the state associated with Q class is nothing but S2. So seeing from S2, S2 goes to S0, that is nothing from P class. So I'll write down here P, and we're talking about S2 here. Okay, P comma, S2 goes to S0, that is P, because S0 is from P class, and S2 goes to S1. Now S1 is from the R class that we have designed here, so P comma R will be here. Now let's talk about the S1. So talking about S1, what we have here is S1 goes to S2, and S2 is from class Q, so I'll write down here Q comma S1 goes to S1. Next state S1 is this, and S1 is from P class, so I will write down here S1 is from R class. We have shifted from P to R, we have defined a new class R, so it will be Q comma R. So this is the final partition method used, because further you cannot classify these classes because we don't have two states in a single class. That was we are having here S0 and S1, there are two states in the class, so we are divided separately into R class. Now each class having only a single state. Now depending on this, what we have here is number of flip-flops required. So the formula is to find out the number of flip-flops required to implement this reduced state diagram. We'll find out the first of all. What we'll do here, first of all, we'll find out the reduced state diagram depending on this final expression. So this is the final state table what we have here is. And depending on this table, we'll draw the state diagram. So three states are there. So I'll write down the states S0, S1 and S2. Talking about first, that is S0. So S0 goes to S0 when input is 0, output is 0. And S0 goes to S1 for input is 1 and output is 0, as you can see here. Talking about S1, S1 goes to S2 for input 0, output also 0, and S1 goes to S1 itself for input is equal to 1 and output is 0. And the last case, what we have here for S2 goes to S0 for input is 0 and output is also 0, and S2 goes to S1 when input is 1 and output is 1. So this is the reduced state diagram.